How you can get or receive data between components in Vue.js. Let's start right now. Hello, creative developer. My name is Mario. Welcome to this video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about Vue.js, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Now, components are the most parts of your application, and you have probably wondered how to get or receive data from one component to the other. This is the topic in this video today, and I will explain it to you by a simple example as well as I can. Imagine you have two components. The first is the app component, and the other is a list component to display a simple list. Now, when you create a component and use it in another component, these two components interact with each other. A component that renders another component in its template is the parent component. And the component used in another is the child component. And these two components can now get or receive data directly. Now, you will see this here in action. In the last video, I explained how to create, use and register components. If you have not seen the video, I link it in the info card. I have opened the app.vue file with our root component and I already created the list.vue component and imported it into the app.vue file. Here below, this is already registered in the components property. In my data property, I have a simple array of example records and I want to output them in the list component now. But how do you get this array into the list component? Now, as first, you can use this component directly here as selector in the template, and now you have the option to specify attributes directly in the selector of the component and bind them. You can choose the name you want. I've write list data. And now the data you want to pass to the component, so the array here. With this, you can transfer data from the parent component to the child component. But that's only the first part. You also have to pick up the data in the child component. Here in the list.vue file, I want to pick up now the data we get from our root component. Vue provides a property called props, and this property is an array for easy usage, more in a second. And here in this array, we can now write all the attributes we want to pick up. In this case, list data. And more is not necessary at this point. Now, you can use it like a normal data attribute in your template and in any method, and so on. Let's do that quickly by creating an unsorted list here with a list item. And this list item has a v4 loop outputting our array. I take the index here as a key and I output the item here. If I save now, you can see the list in the browser. Okay, that works very well. There is a small problem here. It is not sure if the given data is an array or at least an iteratable value. It's recommended here when picking up the values also to specify the data type, which one expects and whether the given attribute is a required attribute. For this, we can not use an array, but should use an object. And with our attribute here, the quotes now have to go away because it's now an object property. As value, we can now specify the data type we want. In this case, an array. It is also possible to specify several data types in an array here. For example, you could also specify an object here, but I think an array as a data type should be enough for this example. If an attribute is really essential to this component, then you can also include that here by making an object from the value as well. You can now specify the data type as type. And now you can set require equal to true. You can also validate the value. You can do this with the attribute validator, which of course is a function. Between the parentheses, you get the value automatically passed, and you can now validate them in the function. As a simple example, I want to return true if the array length does not exceed 5 items. If the validation fails or the data type is not correct, Vue will issue a warning in the browser console when you are in development mode. This is of course very helpful when you work in a team and develop a component that is used by others and you want to make sure that the data here matches a certain pattern. Okay, that was just one way, so how do you get data from the parent component into the child component? And now it's about the other way back and it works a little differently. You cannot pass any data directly to the parent component here. Instead, you have to trigger an event that executes a function in the parent component in the end. And this event you can now give data or not, depending on whether this is necessary in the specific case or not. Now, how you can trigger this event? In this example here in the before loop, I want to use a click event for each element. And if I click here, I want to pass to the parent component on which item was finally clicked. Okay, let me write the click event here and between the quotes you can now trigger the event for the parent component directly or via a method. I do that right here and you can do that with $emit and this is a function that expects a name as the first parameter and that's totally up to you. I'm writing clicked item here. And as a second parameter you can now pass the data, in this case the value. And that's it. Let's go to the other one, the app component. Now here we have to intercept the triggered event in the child component. You can now do this directly at the selector of the component and catch it now with add. And now it is very important that you write here the exact name that you have specified here in the child component. If this is not correct, the event cannot be triggered here. So, in this case, you should write clicked item. And here between the quotation marks, you can now specify any method that should execute the event now. I call this time getClickedItem. Now I create a method here. And this method now automatically gets the value you passed in the child component as the second parameter here in the emit function. You can write any name here, I just use value. And so you can take data from the child component. In my function here I pass the value to a local attribute this.clickedItem. And create it in my local data attribute and output it here in the template. I save and if I click on any item, the value appears. This is a very simple example, but this is basically how you can get or receive data between two components. Have fun with Vue.js.